That night, he makes her read to him about a tree that once ran in great vertical veins of living ore from Georgia to Newfoundland, out through Canada and past the Great Lakes to where they camp out together by lamplight. She tells him about giants 4 feet wide, their trunks shooting 80 feet straight up before the first sideways branches bothered to extend. Trees that stood in endless stands that darkened the air with pollen each spring. The clouds of golden dust raining down on the decks of ships far out to sea. She reads to him of how the English first swarmed a continent that rose from the ocean overnight, seeking masts for their Leviathan frigates and ships of the line. Masts that no place in all stripped Europe, not even the farthest boreal north, could any longer provide. She shows him paintings of Pinus Strobus in hulking shafts as big as church steeples, so valuable that the crown branded even those that stood on private land with the king's broad arrow. And her husband, who spent his life protecting private property, must see it coming, even from the future. The pine tree riot, revolution, war, fought over a thing that grew on these shores long before humans came down out of trees.